Can't breathe. Oh. Flood man. Oh baby, I'm a flood man. 6 feet two, weighing 300 pounds. I'm a flood man. Oh baby, I'm a flood man. Holy cow, what a session. Wow, man, my shoulders are just so pumped that it hurts to let them hang. It hurts to raise them. It hurts to move. They're so pumped. Oh my gosh. Front squats, basically the same plan as last week. 7 second pause in the hole, 15 second hold at the top. Go for a solid single. Over last week, was 105. Today was 135. Holy cow, 66 pound jump. But last week I was feeling like crap and it was a deload. Drop down to the drop sets, two sets of two. Went down to 85 kilos plus. I had a 20 kilo plate on each weight releaser. Holy cow, my shoulders, I just want them to hang. Pockets, I'm trying pockets. So I stick my thumb in my shorts. Maybe that'll help. I don't know. I don't know if I lean on something. Maybe, and I need something to lean on this side. Holy goodness. Weight releasers, 10 second negative instead of a 12 second negative. No pause on the first rep. Second rep is obviously without the weight releasers. Again, with a 7 second pause in the hole, 15 second hold before it's re-racked. Two sets of two. I got really, really feeling good on those. Man, if I hold this chain. No, that's not working either. Man, I'm gonna face this way. Oh my gosh. I felt really, really good with the weight releasers and I got it. I got the pressure off of my knees and onto the mid quads, which is where it needs to be for the overhead press, guys. Today's the first day that I can remember in years that I've done a front squat or a movement where I've been able to apply the pressure mid-thigh and not lower quads, not butt, hips, hamstrings, and back. And I think the slow negative and having to fight with the bands, add extra bands on those sets too. Fighting with the extra bands, having to, you know, I don't want to swing because I want the weight releaser to stay in line. I want everything to be perfect. I want to be upright. I want it to transfer over to my overhead press. You do that overhead press and you're, you know, the log and you dip down to right here. If your knees go forward, the pressure goes on your knees. And then you're basically kind of front calf raise, ankle knee jumping, you know, with some low back. But if you can, you know, if you can keep that chest up and dip only as low as you can maintain that upper body arch and you can apply that pressure to mid thigh instead of knee, then you can jump up and explode the quads, the glutes, and the important part of the back actually into that log and be explosive with it. That's what I'm looking for, and magically I hit that today. I did one more set. I had another 10 kilo plate per side, and I just wanted a fun single. That was it. No pause, no holds, nothing, just a good fun single. I want it to feel good. Oh my goodness, my shoulders. I need the pump to go away. I need the pump to go away. Who are these idiots that say they enjoy a pump? After that, that's pretty much legs. And I don't need a whole, I do need leg try. I do need hamstrings and I need some leg extensions, things like that. But, you know, if you keep in mind that Sunday is deadlifts plus stiff legs. And then, you know, maybe play with an event outside. And then on Sunday or Monday, I'm loading sandbags. And doing some mobility, maybe some cardio work. Wednesday is what you got here. And then Friday is Atlas Stones. So, you know, my legs are getting a pretty good amount of work. I need to pull back from one of those days if I'm going to do some hamstrings, if I'm going to do some leg extensions, if I'm going to do some other stuff. Or it has to be just therapeutic in nature, which is the stuff that I can do at home. Finished there, went straight over to the incline dumbbells. It's rained all day, rained. There was water that fell from the sky off and on all day. So the ground's just a little bit muddy out there. And I did the incline dumbbells last week for my 10 sets of six. This week is supposed to be 10 sets of six, a little bit harder. And I don't want to add weight, so I cut my rest periods down. Last week, I think I did like a set of three, three sets and then three sets. And then, you know, two sets and one set or I don't know. So this week I did five and then three and then two. Kept my rest periods down to about 45 seconds or so. Delts are on fire. I made it through last two sets. I could really feel last set. I really felt. And I think I'm done. I don't think there's anything else I can do for shoulders that's going to be more than what I've already done. I finished off with a set of lat pull downs, a set of tricep punch downs, and a set of abs, and then I can go through stuff like that again tonight. It just those three things help kind of reset the body whenever you're out of whack. So I feel pretty good right now as far as balance, but I'm leaving here, going straight to pick up oldest son, wife, youngest son home, get all my stuff inside, youngest son to bed, wife and oldest son to bed in whatever order they decide they're going to bed, and then I will work a few hours, and then And then, guys, Kentucky plays basketball at 2 a.m. So I'll be watching that game from 2 a.m. till about 4:30, crash to bed, and then begin all over tomorrow. So I know that I'm going to be messed up a little bit, you know, by the time halftime comes around, so I can get out, do another set of abs, triceps, and lats, and reverse hypers at home and correct a whole bunch of that. So hope you enjoyed it. Hope you learned something. Hope you like the new camera angles. And see you guys on Friday night, hopefully for some Atlas Stones or some log presses. Log press. Later, dudes. What's up, my people? My peoples.
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm good. I'm good.
I'm showing my boss. You.
No, we're leaving, Steven. Bye.
Bye.
Hi, Steven. You okay? That's my friend. Let me elevate to the jury.
Hey, buddy. Did you have fun? Hey.
Cheese.
Cheese. You say go big blue?
Go big blue.